Notice that Windows 11 has given Microsoft Paint a new look? Well, in this video, we will look at some of the new features. For a more in-depth look at the topic, check out the article in the description. Opening the new Paint is pretty much like any other versions. You can go to the Start menu, go to All Apps, look for Paint. If it is a program that you use often, you can pin it to the Start menu, or you can even pin it to the taskbar. The look has changed a lot. You'll see rounded corners, changed toolbar icons and symbols, and it has a new UI. You'll also see drop-down menus for the brushes, and a new rounded color palette. In the top menu ribbon, you'll see the tools placed category-wise. The first step is in editing image, is to import or copy and paste the image to the Paint app. So the first tool set in the menu ribbon is the paste and import. You can either directly import your image or copy it to the clipboard by pressing Control C and pasting it to the Paint app. You can also click on the file option in the main menu ribbon and open the image. There is the scissors symbol to cut a portion, or you can press Control X from the image and place that in the clipboard using the Control C option. The next set of tools include the cut, the crop, and rotate tools. There are not many changes in this tool set except the symbol of the resize tool. And the rest are the same as if we had MS Paint in Windows 10. The next set of tools, of course, you'll have the pencil, the eraser, the paintbrush, the color picker, a bucket, text, magnifier. They're pretty much the same as they were in the earlier version of Paint. Eraser here is to correct the mistakes, but you can also use the shortcut Control Z to undo any changes or correct your mistakes. Adding the text has changed some, though. To add text to your image in the Paint app, you'll click on the letter A, and you'll see a new ribbon open up that will give you, of course, the font size, whether you want it in bold, whether you want it in italic, underline, strike through. And if you noticed, the left, center, and right wasn't an option that was available in previous versions of Paint. And whether or not we want to create a box around it or fill the background. Brushes are, again, one of the most important tools in the MS Paint app. In the main menu ribbon, you'll see a drop-down menu where you can select the brush as per your requirements. If you want a calligraphy, you want marker. Next comes the tool set, which has, of course, the different shapes. We can do diamonds, arrows. Pretty much, this has stayed the same as previous versions. Also, if you want to adjust the thickness of your brush strokes, you can use this particular icon. The last in the tool menu is the color palette. Earlier we had the labels of color 1 and color 2. Now you just see two circles on the left side of the color palette, which is the new color 1 and the new color 2. The circle at the top, of course, is color 1, the primary color, and the bottom one, the secondary color, is color 2. Just need to click on the circle to activate it and choose the color that you want to be primary or secondary color. And you can, of course, customize colors by pressing the far right color palette and either putting in the hex number, the RGBs, and create a palette of your choice.
For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.